keep going over the world we knew once when you walked
beside. Hello, Mr. Harris.
Can I call you Arthur?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay then, Arthur. Can I ask you a few questions about the murder of Mr. Wilson last night?
Oh, yeah, of course.
Excellent. Can you please describe what happened yesterday?
Certainly. I was sitting at my desk on the second floor of our building when I heard a noise come from upstairs. I decided it must have come from Mr. Wilson's office, so I went upstairs to check on him. I found the door to his study closed, but was almost certain that the noise I heard was coming from within. I reached for the doorknob and froze with terror as I saw a shadowy figure holding a knife above Mr. Wilson. Plunged the knife into his chest, repeatedly stabbing him over and over. It was terrible. I wanted to look away, but my eyes were glued to the horrific scene. Eventually, that cold-hearted villain released his body and Mr. Wilson fell to the floor like a cold sack of potatoes. My heart was racing. I could hardly control my breathing. Suddenly, his head snapped towards me and...
And then what, Arthur?
I ran. I ran as fast as I could to the office next door to call the police. The killer must have escaped, or else you probably wouldn't be here asking me questions.
Thank you. You've helped me to paint a better picture of the situation. Now, I must ask, what was your relationship like with Mr. Wilson?
Oh, it was great. He was as kind-hearted as they come. Never worked for a better man.
I see. And can you describe the physical appearance of the perpetrator?
Well, it was dark. I could hardly see anything. All the lights in the room were turned off. I could only make out a silhouette of what looked like an average height man. Slick back hair, dressed in all black. I'm sorry, but that's all I could make out.
Well, that doesn't narrow down the pool much, but... Tell me, Arthur. Can you think of any reason why somebody might have wanted to kill Mr. Wilson?
Oh, no. Like I said, he was kind to everyone he knew. Well, there is this one person. His old partner, Mark Walker, was always bitter towards him. It certainly wasn't Mr. Wilson's fault, but Mark seemed to think that he'd come out of the company.
And do you know where I might be able to find Mark?
Not really. I haven't seen him in years. Stopped working there about 6 months after I started.
I see. Well, if there's anything else that you have observed or experienced that might be relevant to this investigation, please let me know.
I don't think... Oh, Mark is missing a finger on his left hand.
And do you remember if the killer was missing a finger?
I honestly can't say.
Well then, thank you, Arthur. If you think of anything, please feel free to reach out.
Of course. Call me if there's anything I can do.